seeing what they have to offer up, and then we will be doing a haul. And surprise, we are doing a large haul at the end that is a bonus haul. I'm really excited to bring it to you guys. These are items that I have been holding off on showing you guys until I had the time to do a large haul. So this is a long video, so grab up something to drink, maybe something to snack on, enjoy the video. The rest of this thrift with me is going to be a quiet thrift with me, so enjoy, and I will see you guys in just a few.
Found the one, you should never give her up. I think it's the way life changes when in love, yeah. I surround my soul with the positivity. That's why I don't worry about the things that I don't see, yeah. These days I don't worry about much. I think we should have some more fun. I still dream about the days when we were young. Oh, yeah.
take a hit and still finish in one. Yeah, yeah. Oh, 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 oh. Memory lane isn't that too far away from our hearts. Yeah, yeah. The ones we keep close, we should never let go. So tell me who you love, baby. Take a moment to unwind, fix yourself and realign yourself with the world, baby. Breathe slow, baby.
Okay, guys, on this journey, I found a few items, so I'm going to go up and get checked out, and then we will get straight to the haul. I'm really excited for you guys to see what I got, and make sure and stay tuned because we have a bonus haul. Hi guys, well, I'm really glad that you guys got to go on that thrift with me. So I'm going to go ahead and show you the items that I happened to pick up there. First of all, I am really excited about these. I have seen them on Instagram. I've seen them on YouTube. People trying to spin these after putting them in hot water and making them swirly. But I happened to find two really beautiful, kind of a gray blue candle. And let's see if I can get that in there. Sorry, the lighting is so terrible because it is night. I picked those up for 99 cents. So I was pretty excited about these. I burned a lot of candles and I like to find them at the thrift store. It's just a lot less expensive to find them that way. I would venture to think that if I was to find something like this, it could cost up to probably $12.99 to $16.99, maybe $9.99, but the quality of these are really high, and they were still in the packaging, and they're in really good shape. So if you know me and you've watched my channel for any amount of time here recently, I've been really big on baskets, and the only thing that I'm searching for right now are flat baskets. I have plenty of baskets that have handles. I have probably 4, 5, 6 baskets that are on the larger scale. I actually even have a really large square basket that is extremely old. And one of these days when I do a tour of my home, if I haven't sold it, then you will see that then, I am going to redo the patio. I'm really excited for spring. I'm sure you guys are too. I did just do a little, thrift with me to see what they were bringing out for Easter and the spring, because it's starting to kind of fall into the stores. You're starting to see it. And St. Patty's Day, of course, we won't forget St. Patty's Day, the luck of the Irish. But anyways, so I found this basket because I just didn't want to find anything that wasn't flat. So this one, I did pay up a little bit. It's $2.99 for the price on that. You can see that there. So I like it because it's just a really light color, and you could use it just as a bowl. It does have just a little kind of scooped out area here, and the weave on it is pretty tight. It looks like it is bamboo, and it's wicker. So because you can find them like this and they are seagrass. So that was that. Next, I have some other baskets that are more on the oriental side, and I just absolutely loved this ladle. I just thought it was so beautiful. You can really see how the light goes through it. It's just a really beautiful color, and I only paid $1.99 for that. So it doesn't have a hole here at the top, but I do have, and I don't wanna put a hole here in this part, and I am gonna keep it, but I have this conversation with my wife all the time because I have a completely different view on how our home should look. And it's very boho right now. Our home in Montana is actually completely different from that. So, and I think about all the stuff I have in Montana and I think, oh gosh, it's so different than it is here. But you know, it's refreshing when we go back there. It's just a different look and a different vibe. But, and we're really lucky to have both places. But I think I have some jute and I will tie something on here or something and maybe I'll put it up on my shelf in the kitchen. But this is something I'm gonna keep, I'm not selling. But like I told my wife, anything in my house can be sold except for probably about a handful of items. You know, like my jewelry, I would wanna keep, my clothes, I would wanna keep, you know, any of my pictures, but you know, any of just the stuff. I've just kind of lived kind of gypsy through my life and it's easier for me to kind of give things up and move on and have a new adventure. And that's why it's really fun with thrifting. You can do that. And so that's another reason why I am introducing this channel to YouTube and to you guys as my subscribers. I'm just over 100. I can't wait to see how many more people I get on my channel. But I just think it's really important to value the items that you purchase, whether you keep them in your home or whether you're going to resell them. If you're going to resell them, sometimes you have to live with them. And you might as well have something in your home that you love. And you know, if you're gonna sell it, then you have already, you know, you already know in your mind that's what you're going to do. So, you know, like something like this picture that's right here, this is actually a really large map of Portland. And we live in an apartment complex where actually my wife and grandson are going downstairs right now to take recycling. But when we take down recycling, we find things that people are getting rid of. And so I told her, I said, you need to videotape me and let me know what's going on down there. I want to know what's down there because there's a lot of really good stuff this week. And so that might be another adventure that I will take you guys on, and how to find things inexpensive or cheap and also free. I mean, it's really exciting the stuff that we could find here in the spring and the summer on the side of the road. So, but anyways, I am gonna stop rambling on and thank you guys for stopping by. And I'll be right back with the second part of this haul. And we will have a whole new vibe. I'm really excited for you guys to see this whole collection. Like I said, it might be some of the stuff that I have already shown you guys, and a lot of it is new. So stay tuned and we'll get started. Okay guys, welcome back. So this is a large collection, and this video might get a little long. If it starts getting too long, I'm gonna shut it down and I'm gonna do a part two so that we have, you know, a good time of seeing these items. So we're just gonna get started and see how long it runs. So let's go. So in going to the thrift stores in the Portland area, I'm really, really fortunate on what I can find while I'm there. And I find a lot of bags. And I'm pretty excited about, I would say 99% of these, because I'll use them myself, but if I sell it, great. You know, I'm excited about it. In October, I was in a pretty bad car accident, and it was a pain in the butt to be on a scooter for, because I couldn't put any weight on my foot. I had broke my foot and had two screws put in it. So I found a fanny pack, And I used it quite a bit. It came from Target. It's just a really soft gray, or excuse me, tan pink color. And I really liked it because it's a really good color. And I like the clasp on it. It's really easy to use. And being a plus size girl, it fits really well. So that's that. The next one, my kind of go-to, because I just kind of sling it over my body, is this beautiful black bag. Another find at the Goodwill. This is street level. I even have change in here. And the other one, I had a receipt and a mask. So it's got... I don't feel like I go wrong when I purchase stuff at the Benz because I get such a great deal. So the next one that I got, this really cute tan bag. I was hoping maybe I kept, sometimes they keep tags on stuff so that I remember, so that I don't have to think, oh, what did I pay for that? I need to start logging stuff. But I found this really cute tan bag. And it just has a zipper in the back. And it has this really cute polka dot blue and white fabric on the inside. This is also street level. So that was an awesome little find. I know I have showed you guys this little fanny pack. I actually found two of these at the Goodwill. Just leather, old vintage. Let's see here. So then I also at the Benz picked up this little number, and it's got just these cute little, they look like they're beads, but they're not beads, but they're super cute. Good to just take to the beach, whatever. A little coin purse. I do pick up a lot of wallets. I mean, they practically weigh nothing. So when I put stuff in the closet, I store stuff inside of these bags. So don't mind me chucking it aside. So next I found this really cute little orange, terracotta orange bag. And I found this one at the Benz, and it's just really fun. I know. Mel, she's always asking me, so what do you do with all those bags? And I'm like, either I'll sell it or use it, or I'll do both. So next, I love a good bag. Like, I love a good bag. And I was at the Benz, and I found this one, threw it in the washer, washed it, conditioned the handles because they're leather. But this is from Will Leather Goods, which they have one downtown Portland. And this one is from Eugene, I believe, but thought that was a really great bag. We go to the Fred Meyer's, which is the local grocery store. And these are Dickie backpacks. So you can see that, sorry. My light is terrible. So $56. They were 75% off. So, you know, you do the numbers. I thought it was a great color. And if anything, I can donate it to one of the kids that are, when they do go back to school. So let's see, here's that second fanny pack. So this is a Mary Ann something or other. Girl needs glasses, don't tell anybody. I don't know if it's real snake skin or not. Have no clue, but I just thought really cute, just little clutch. It's got a couple of compartments, you know, if you wanted to throw your phone or whatever. And when we do get to go out, I think it is just really cute, super cute. Or I can sell it, like I said. So one day I went into the Goodwill in Hillsboro, I believe it is. It's another store that I haven't been to on my channel. I'm excited. I'm gonna go to it probably the next time that I go out, because it is one of my favorites. I have two in the Beaverton area that I go to quite often. They're just like, hey, I'm gonna run to Goodwill. Hey, I'm gonna go to Goodwill. You know, but the other ones, like, if I get to go by myself, I always go to this one. It was actually the first one that Mel and I went to when we came to Portland. But they had a slew of Coach bags the day that I was in there. Mel was out running with her daughter, so I took advantage of going. I'm going to set that aside because I have a little story I'm going to tell you, but I'm going through the store and I think I probably picked up, by the way, this is one of my other go-to faves. So it's totally authentic. I hope you can see that or not. I'm sorry. Let's see if I can't get that in there. There you go. So while at the bins one day, with one of my little Coach wristlets like this, but it was the black one with the little gray Coach emblem on there, I threw a pair of jeans. I hardly ever go through clothes. I hardly ever do. This is before my car accident. And my mom's there and I'm just going through the bins and whatever, and I threw those jeans and I know that that's when it was, but my wallet went with the wall. My wallet went and I just kind of shut down for a minute and I screamed at everybody to stop what they were doing and to please help me try to find it. And of course, nobody gave it to me. But the moral of the story is that it was all profit. And so hopefully somebody enjoyed that $350 or plus that was in there. And bought a lot of really great stuff for their family. So whatever. But don't ever wear a wristlet when you go to the Goodwill bins because you're sure to lose it. So most of the time I leave my money in the car. They know I go out to the cart, I get my money or get the card, whatever. And I just put my keys in my pocket and use my phone to video for you guys and just find all the good stuff and then go get the money to pay. But anyways, so I do have this up on the classifieds for sale right now. This is a double-sided bag from Portugal. And I'm not really sure what they use it for, but can you imagine taking this to the farmer's market? So I don't know. He might have to go to the farmer's market with me. We only have a couple of months and we'll be able to do that. So up next, I did pick up a couple of wallets. I don't know how this one I don't know how this one ended up in there because it's in pretty rough shape. But, you know, you can clean leather. Cows get wet. And I've cleaned quite a few of bags, and have had very great success. And they were also Coach bags. So I picked up this bag the last time that I was at the Benz. It was on my last video. It still has the retail tag on it. It is $37, crossbody, leather, large size bag. So never used, great, beautiful bag. So next, when I go back and forth to Montana or just on a day trip, I just wanted a bag that zipped. So I found this Victoria's Secret 2014 London bag. It does have the little bag that you put like your makeup in, whatever that goes with it. And then I picked up this one the last time I was at the Benz, or maybe the time before that. It's just a really subtle kind of greeny gray bag, and the inside of it is green, and it's just a cute little zip up, great to take to the beach or, you know, what have you. But I just thought it was really cute and probably easy to sell, but I think that it will be just a little bit longer before I post bags. I would say probably, I don't know, another week or so, and then I'll really post up some bags. So while I was at the Benz one day, I found a lot of these sleeves. So I picked them all up. I just grabbed them all because I thought they were great just to put shoes in or put handbags in if you were traveling or what have you. And this is the one that is inside of that sleeve. So it's super cute. It's just got a cheetah print on it. And I picked this up at the Goodwill. This one was $9.99. That was in the Goodwill Benz. So super light, really, really light. So I thought that was a really good find, and it's perfectly clean. It had the tag still from Goodwill. I'm not sure why nobody bought it there, because I think it's seriously cute. So let's see what we have in this bag. These are some little fluffy inserts that I picked up for my boots, and you could just cut them down. So I think those were $2.99 at Goodwill. See, you never know what you're gonna find in one of my bags that were shoved in the closet. So up next, I have this really cute green bag. It has this little front pocket and this leather piece that comes down and snaps right to the front of the bag, just like so. And it has this really cute little piece that just hangs there. Isn't that super cute? I just love it. And the inside of it is just really super cute too. So, you know, just a great bag just to throw your wallet and your keys. And it does have the little piece here if you wanted to clip your keys, but I would never recommend anybody doing that. But you can also find a really cute leather charm maybe that you could put on there, or you know, just to style it up a little bit. So let's see. Oh, I love this bag. Here's another one of those little bags. That one's black and white. So yay, spring is coming and I'm super excited. So yes, I found this one at the Benz. So I'm so, oh my gosh, I'm so excited. So super cute. Look at the strap on that. It's so cute. It has this really cute leather tassel. Yeah, super cute with that whole woven look there on the front. Look at how clean that is. Brand new, never used. brand new at the bins. And this probably weighs, I don't know, a pound. So that was a great little find. So I think we might make it through this, guys. Okay. Goodwill, Cedar Hills, where I always go. I found this really cute little bag. It's all leather. It looks like it used to have a mirror right here, maybe, but I could not resist it. It's so cute. Look at that. So cute. I love it. It's got like a knot here on the top of the strap. And look at the top of that. Isn't that so, like, how could you leave that behind? So let me tell you, because I know that I bought this at Goodwill, not at the bins. I'm hoping that I left the sticker in it. Let's see, I have some little cute little wallets in here. No sticker, probably $5.99, $6.99, something like that. So that was, I love stuff like that. I found this really cute wallet. And I have so used this, there's change in there. But there's this really cute wallet and it's just got these little coin compartments in there. And this is genuine leather and it's made by Pipe. And my receipt. Let's see what my receipt's for. I'm joking. So let's see here. Cute little guy, easy to travel with, maybe with just like your extra money that you just don't want, you know, maybe just an ID or just something simple to carry. And then I love this. It's so super cute. Look at that. Isn't that adorable? And it's just so tiny. Oh, still has the tag. $1.99. I paid $1.99 for that. Isn't it so adorable? So, yeah. Can't go wrong with that. Like, you can't buy that at Walmart or any place in the mall. Like, come on now. So, this is a little guy that I've had forever. I've probably had this little owl that I picked up at the Goodwill, actually, in Montana. I've had this little owl, and it just clips, so it's kind of easy for extra money or just change. When you're traveling, that's what I use it for because it's just soft and I can just kind of shove it in my bag. But I've probably had that thing for like 7 years or something. So this is another one of those little bags that I found. This is a Nike one and this is actually cloth. So it's super nice. You could throw your blow dryer in there and, you know, or some good leather shoes or what have you and take that traveling. So I'm trying to get through this. I know we're at almost 20 minutes. So this is the next bag that I picked up. Goodwill Benz. Guy had it in his basket. I remember it clearly. I've already told this story, but I was like, oh, I love that bag. And he said, oh, Senorita, you have it. I'm like, okay, thank you so much. I'm in love with it. So it's just like a little bucket bag, but it would just be super easy to take to farmer's market or to the beach or I don't know, just grocery shopping, whatever. Super cute. It'd even be cute for the winter time. Look at it. It looks like snowflakes on there. It's so super cute. So let's see here. This is a black bag that I picked up at the bins. This has like a jeweled, another mask in there. It's not in the best shape. This is one that I actually have listed for $5. Just a simple bag, just black, just to, you know, have to, for your everyday use. This would be a great bag, especially if you have kids and they're kind of destructive and, you know, you just have to be kind of careful and then you use your good bags when you go someplace special. But special for us anymore is just the grocery store, right, ladies? I just think that that's normal for us anymore. Get excited when you go grab a coffee and you go to the grocery store. I'll call my mom up and say, dress up, we're going to the grocery store. So up next is this wicker bag, and it has a turtle right here. That was a huge selling point for me. And then this button here, and this just comes off. Sorry about that. Comes off, and then you just put it right back on there and just carry the bag. So super cute. I just really thought that was just super cute. So for the beachy, you know, spring, just right about the middle of spring, I'll start putting stuff out that's beachy. And here people start going to the beach about the end of March. So this is another black bag. This is a little backpack that has a Nike swoosh on it. And that was part of that big group of bags that I picked up. So this is another Coach bag that I picked up. And I just been kind of holding tight, just waiting for spring. And so I don't know what year this came out in. Let me take a look here. So it looks like 09. Let's see. Yeah, it looks like it's 09 is when this bag came out. It's got the pink on the inside. This is one that I actually put in the sink, scrubbed. It was so terribly dirty. And I don't highly recommend it. It's really up to you guys and your leather bags. But I put some elbow grease into it with some dish soap, and then I conditioned it with leather conditioner. And I think it turned out beautiful. I mean, if you guys saw what it looked like before, you guys would be disgusted and like, that's the bag you would left behind. And this was one of those Goodwill finds. I did take out the tag because I washed it. When I did get it, I was kind of confused about this zipper right here. And I thought, oh my gosh, I think it's broken. I shouldn't have grabbed that one. And then I got to looking and it does. It zips just fine. I didn't realize that, you know, because most bags, they just stop. Well, this one, you just unzip and the whole thing comes open. And then you could just, like the bottom of your coat, just zip it up. So I'll probably use it once, maybe twice, and then I'll post it. So let's see. So this bag I was so excited for. Like, you know when you go to Goodwill or you go to the bins or any of your thrift stores or you're out yard sailing or estate sales, whatever, and you see something and your heart goes p-p-p-p-p-p. And you're like, like the other day, if you guys saw my video, and I had that wicker table, and I said if I would have saw somebody grab it, I probably would have body slammed them. Well, I felt the same way, and I'm at this bin, and I'm going through all of these purses the same time I found all these and some of these other bags, because there was a lot of really good bags inside this bin. So I'm going through it, and lo and behold, I'm like, I'm so happy. This is what I found. So I am just floating on cloud nine. I'm so excited. And I did see that there was a little bit of damage on it. And so it's something that I really need to tend to. I have used this bag a couple of times myself, and I thought that I had tended to it the first time and whatever I did didn't work. So the inside of this is a really beautiful butter color. It is just absolutely gorgeous. The tag on it, let's see if I can get that in there so you guys can see it. Okay. So during the excitement of this, I'm like, I come home, I'm telling my wife, look at what I found, look at what I found. Oh my gosh, I can't believe it. I look it up and it's worth all this money and I'm so excited and I'm just really looking at all of the hardware and I'm looking it up online and I'm like, oh my gosh, I can't believe it. I'm so excited. This is like the best find ever. Best find ever. No, it's not real. But, you know. If it makes a girl feel good, then, you know, carry the bag, you know, like it's all about the story and how funny it is. And I mean, it's just like you go out to lunch at the mall with all of your friends and you buy this expensive bag and it costs like all of this money. I get the same feeling when I go to the thrift store and I find something that I fall in love with that I think is gonna work in my world. And I'm so excited for, and I'm so passionate about like keeping it out of our landfill. I thought, can you imagine if that went to our landfill? Seriously, like seriously, could you imagine if that went to our landfill? Why? Why does it have to go? So this is another Coach bag that I found. This one was from the Goodwill, where I had the day of finding Coach bags. This is an older bag, yes, but it's in fantastic shape. I washed it and have not used this one. I'm not clear if it can have a longer handle. If it had a longer handle, it would be mine. You know, I would use it a couple times, but you know, I will be happy to, as I mean, it's clean, so I'll be happy to get it online. This is another question. So I was thinking, I wonder, and comment below and let me know. Okay. So here's my thought. Do you guys want to start being able to purchase some of the items that I thrift for or that I find? Do you guys want to be able to do that? Because if so, please comment below and let me know. I would put up a website and take pictures and price everything out and start maybe selling off of a website. I'd be happy to do that. It might be just a little bit of work, but I think it would be kind of fun. Comment below and let me know if you guys would like to do that. If you guys like some of the things that I find and if you would like to start purchasing them. So I think we have about maybe half dozen things left. So we'll just go ahead and get this over with and not do a second video. So this is the next bag that I found. Super cute. Let me tell you who it's made by. It's the BOC. See it in there? Super cute. Just got a little snap for the clasp. And then this one right here in the front. So that's super cute. I like that. That's a cute little bag. So this is another crossbody. It does have some damage here, but I thought maybe if I was to maybe find like a vintage belt or something, that I would just take that off and just put something new on there. But this was another one that I found at the bins. I think my mom found this and said, hey, I think you would like this. And so it ended up in my cart and it came home with me, but it's all good. This is another Coach bag. It doesn't have the other part of the zipper, so that would need to be replaced. But that is just the inside of it. And that was from the Goodwill. And this one is just a cute little crossbody with black and white on the inside, two zippers on the outside, cute tassels, and no tag. I want to say that it might be Target. I want to say that's probably Target. Don't hold me to it, but I would say it's Target. So, love the bins. love the Benz because this is super cute. So this is Free People. Little change. Great. And this is the bag. And they were actually together, so I was pretty excited about that. So I really just want to know, you guys, if you guys want to start purchasing some of the stuff that I find, you know, let's talk about it. You know, let's have conversation. Let me know. We'll see if it's worth doing. I'm sure that it will. I'll be happy to do it for you guys. So this is another great bag. This is a great tote. And it actually, the clasp on it, I've used it a few times, has a magnet in it. So it's really nice to just throw over your shoulder. It's really comfortable and it's easy to hold. A lot of totes are like they're too short and you don't have enough room. And especially with me being a plus size woman, I like to have a good bag. It's really important. But so the last thing that I wanted to show you guys, I picked these up. They're not bags, but they're boots. And they're so cute. Look at the back of those. Aren't those adorable? These are a size 11. And I hoped that they would fit me, but maybe in the future. But I would much rather sell them. The heel on these are pretty short. Just a sweet little heel. Still has the tag on the bottom, so they've never been worn. And I paid $6.99 at the Goodwill for those. So I just want to say thank you guys for being patient and watching my video today. I know it's a lot longer than you probably anticipated. And I am so happy to be here with you guys and share some of these really big hauls and some of the stuff that I've been kind of hoarding and waiting to do a big haul for you guys. Again, thank you so much for watching today. It means a lot when you guys share to your friends and that you guys have subscribed. So when you share to your friends and you tell them, hey, make sure and ring that bell.